Blue?
Check. We're gonna just use two mics today, so what do you want? Blue and green or yellow and white or what? Green and white? Green. We'll use green. You can use yellow or white? Yellow? We'll use yellow. Red. He said we're only going to need two handhelds. I can't hear a word you're saying. Yellow and green. I'm going to leave these down here, but power it off. Check one. That's good. Thank you. Thank you.
Good morning. This morning I'm going to read the 91st number of Psalms, verses 1 and 2. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust.
Lord, thank you for letting us be here today. Lord, thank you for letting everybody else come and making their way. Lord, let us have a good service today. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. I would ask that if you're sitting on the very end of your pew, you might want to slide in. Unless you want to get hit by a ribbon.
give our children another hand. Amen. 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 We're so excited about the expressions of worship. Amen. Thank God we have so many children and they want to do it. Amen. Isn't that a blessing? We don't have to make them. All right. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, young ladies. Right. We are so glad to see each and every one of you here today. Are you glad to be here today? Amen. Amen. I'm excited about God, and I'm excited about what God is doing in the life of our church, and I thank God for each and every one of you, and my praise is not predicated on whether Alabama win or not. Hallelujah. Amen. I can still worship God. Amen. Amen, amen. And so we thank God for each and every one of you. We do want to welcome each of all of our guests here today. We want to welcome those that are streaming live on Ustream. Thank God for you and those that are in the sanctuary. If you're here for the very first time, we just want you to know that you're special to us. Just slip your hand up and let us know that you're here. And we want to let you know that you're special to us. Anybody, 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 anybody? All right. I believe we all home. Let us stand. As the choir gives us some music, let us fellowship with one another at this time. Amen. Let us stand. All right.
you so very much. Just a few announcements. Of course, our church school, Sunday school is at 11 a.m. We have great teachers, classes for all, from the youngest to the oldest. And so we want you to join us for our Sunday school. Also, Wednesday night services, 6 p.m. prayer, youth fellowship, 6:30 Bible study. And, of course, we live stream for our Bible study and our Sunday worship. If you need information about our church or things going on, you can go on our Facebook page and our website. OBCTuscaloosa.org is our website, and giving is available 24 hours a day. Our radio broadcast is every Sunday, 5 p.m., 107.3 FM, 104.3 FM, and 1280 AM. Our daily prayer conference call is 6:30, 7 days a week. We will resume Minister Trenton. No, we won't. That's a typo. I'll talk to the minister. The minister, see me after this. Thank you all who traveled with me to Montgomery on last week. Thank you so very much. You are so kind, and thank you for all your hard work and your sacrifices. I want to thank those who stood on last Sunday, and some didn't stand to be seen, but we thank you that you made your contributions to our organ donation, and we have the organ is right here, and we thank God. And so we thank God for that. Amen. All right. Also, our youth ministry September community project is Socks for Seniors, and the last day for collecting is today. Listen, we need 100 pair of socks. That's what Glen Haven told us. We need 100 pairs of socks, and so we need you to get your socks in. Today is the last day, okay? All right. Also, a church business meeting will be held the last Wednesday of this month, the September 30th, after Bible study, all right? Business of importance. And also, for about 10 minutes, I need to see members after after worship today, just about 10 minutes. Also, leaders, we are meeting the first Saturday in October. That's if you head up a ministry, if you work in a ministry, I need to see you the first Sunday of October. Now, I do realize that that's still my homecoming. I won't keep you long, all right? So let's meet at 10:30, and it will only take us 30 minutes what we have to do, all right? We also need workers for our children's church, workers for our children's church, and we also need tutors. Anyone willing, interested, want you to see any of our youth workers. I do want to say this. Now, the semester has just started, and I've been talking with our youth workers, our teachers, and I understand that we already have children that are struggling. Now, it's too early for our children to struggle. Amen? Now, all the educators stand up. Amen. Amen. All right. Thank y'all so much. All right. Now, we have educators in our midst. I need you guys, if you can, if you would. All of y'all don't have to come every Wednesday, but I want our children need help. Now, we don't, you know, how they do math now, they don't do it how we did it. And I'm just going to tell you, they get mad when you try to show them your way. They'll tell you quick, well, that ain't what the teacher said. Well, listen, I got my degree. That's what I say. I say, I got mine. You try, but I mean, that ain't the right thing to say. So, I mean, because I be getting hot because they be getting smart because that ain't what the teacher said how to do it. And so we need your help. Progress reports went home, and here's the thing. We're going to have a new rule in our church. Our children have to get their grades to participate. All right? All right? And so we have too many educators in this building, and we have other, and some of you are not educators, but some of y'all good in math. Some of y'all, you know, so we're going to need your help, and we want all our children to have available help. So what our children need to do until, you can have a seat, thank you, until y'all grades start looking good, y'all need to start bringing y'all books on Wednesday night. Amen. Amen. Bring your books, the book bags, all your books, especially the subject that you are struggling in, and we want to help you. Amen? All right, we want to help you, and then we'll do the rest. But education is important. Somebody say amen. Education is important. And so, yes, we're going to teach you things about the Lord, but we want you to be able to excel in school. And so we want to start that immediately. And so I need you guys to please, ma'am, please, sir, donate your time for us, all right? And I can come up and help when I can, right? So I don't want you to do it on your own. All right. Also, let us not forget you're doing a good, great job, but no youth in the balcony. We thank you for that without an adult. Thank you so very much. All right. At this time, we're going to worship the Lord with our giving. And we're going to ask that you prepare your hearts and your mind to give unto the Lord that which he has given unto us. And God has been gracious to us. And he has been kind to us. And we know that Christmas is about 14 weeks away. Have mercy, Jesus. Walmart is setting up layaways. Hallelujah. Amen. And so we understand that. But God loves what kind of giver? All right. God has taken care of us all year long. We can't beat God's giving no matter how hard we try. And so I want you to be intentional about your giving. Be intentional about your giving. Members, please, ma'am, please, sir, use the envelope system. I will say more about that after service, after we get done. But I do need you to do the very best you can. Leaders, you know what you have been asked to do. There's a minimum that you need to do monthly. There's a minimum you need to do monthly. And so we pray to God that you are doing your very best. All right? All right. At this time, our deacon will come. Deacon Word will come and lead us in prayer as we prepare to give unto the Lord.
Heavenly Father, thank you for this day that you have made and prepared for us, Lord. We want to thank you, Lord, for this offering that's about to be given. Lord, bless those that have to give and bless those that don't have to give. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Brother Dickin. All right, at this time, our ushers are ready to serve us, and we will stand on my left and my right. They will direct you around as you come to give your tithe and your offering unto the Lord. Remember, today is the third Sunday, and if this is our youth Sunday, and our benevolent offering goes to them, all right? Our benevolent offering goes to them, so if you want to put something in special for them, you can do it on your envelope, or you can just put it in cash, all right, or however you want to do it. I just wanted to make that announcement. Every third Sunday is our youth Sunday, all right? They will give us some music as we get ready to give. Thank you. children are singing. All right, they're going to sing one more. Come on, give them a hand as they sing.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is
there's power. So there's power. There's power. There's power. There's power in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. To break every chain. My God, our children are singing out of the depths of their soul. Thank God for them. They're going to come down. As they come down and we prepare for our altar call. Yes, yes. I hear the chain falling. As we come to the altar today, first of all, we want to thank God that he looked beyond our faults, that he saw our needs. We're still praising God with Sister Sharon Welch. And amen. She's doing well. The doctors are astonished because she serves the healer. So we thank God that she is out of the hospital, but CJ says that she stays near the hospital for a few weeks to make sure everything is fine. So we thank God for that. And we're just happy and just so overwhelmed of how God has been gracious to her. And the reason that we shout is because the line has moved up. Amen, amen. So as we come to the altar today, we want to, as I said earlier, we want to especially pray for our children, and they have so much pressure on them, and you know, we're living in a world where things are easily accessed, and so we know that this spice epidemic is running rampant with our young people. So we want to plead the blood of Jesus over them. Amen. And then we are going to pray for those that are sick, those that are shut in, those that are bereaved. We're going to pray for your house, our house. We all need prayer. Amen. We all need prayer. You look at this world, you look at this nation, you look at the news, we know that we need prayer. We also want to pray for Brother Foster's shoulder. Lord heals him, amen. And so let us come to the altar. Give me an A flat. Give me an A flat. A flat. All night. All day. The angels
keep watching over me.
Sing it again. Oh, oh. Come on, say it one more time. One more time. Oh, it's all night and it's all day. All day. The angels keep watching over me. Thanksgiving in our heart. We thank you for last night's rest. We thank you for our early rising this morning. As we slumbered and slept between life and death, all night, all day, your angels were camped all around us. God, as the robbers were robbing to and fro, as the sirens were going off in the city last night, you kept us from all hurt, harm, and danger. And for that, God, we just want to say thank you. God, you brought us through this, and you brought us through that. And God, you are the one that sit high, and you are the one that looks low, and you are the one that has all power in your hands. And we're just grateful to call you our God today. God, if we had 10,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you enough. And we're just grateful to have our health and our strength. We're grateful to be in our right minds. God, we know that there are those that awakened this morning that had to wait on somebody to get them out the bed. They had to wait on somebody to put their clothes on. They had to wait on somebody to take them to the restroom. And God, we thank you that it's not because we've been so good. It's not because we've been so kind, but it's because of those twins we call grace and mercy. This afternoon, we want to thank you for your grace and your mercy. God, you sit high and you look low, and we know we were guilty as charged, but we thank you for grace and mercy today. God, grace has brought us safe thus far, and it's grace that will lead us on. Now, God, we pray for every person that's under the sound of my voice. I don't know what they're going through, but I know that you know all, and you see all, and you have all power in your hands. And so, God, where they're burdened down, we pray that you lift them up. God, we're praying for the spirit of depression right now in the name of Jesus. We're praying for wayward children right now in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, for the children from the youngest to the oldest, that God, you let them know that you are the author and finisher of their faith. God, we pray for parents that's trying to raise children in the right way. Sometimes it gets rough. Sometimes it gets tough. Sometimes the hills are hard to climb. But we thank you, God, that you said in your word that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. Now, God, we pray for cancer patients everywhere. We pray, God, that you will heal them if it be thy will. God, there are people under the sound of my voice. The doctors are scratching their heads because they're still walking around looking good. But we know it's because you are a doctor that's never lost a patient. We know that you are the healer, and you heal all manner of diseases. Now, Lord, we do not ask amiss today,
But God, we ask you to touch right now in the name of Jesus. We ask you to heal broken hearts right now in the name of Jesus. We ask you to put families back together again. If it be thy will, now, Lord, we ask that you touch our children. Touch every one of them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet, and let them know that their answer lies within you. And so, God, we thank you. We thank you for health. We thank you for strength. We thank you for life. And we pray right now that everybody under the sound of my voice, if it be thy will, we ask you to touch, God. We ask you to heal, God. We ask you to deliver right now in the name of Jesus. And it is so. We plead the blood of Jesus over our children. We plead the blood of Jesus over our spouses. We plead the blood of Jesus over all our families right now in the name of Jesus. And it is so. And we thank you in advance because you've been a good God. You brought us through this. You brought us through that. And for that, we're grateful. Now, God, we won't send you to the hospital. We won't send you to the nursing home because you're already there. So move like you want to move. Touch like you want to touch. Heal like you want to heal right now in the name of Jesus. Touch hearts, touch minds right now, God. Hallelujah. Touch, God. Heal, deliver, and set free. But before we close this prayer, we haven't done all you told us to do. Forgive us for our sins. Forgive us for our transgressions. It's me, oh Lord. It's not my mama. It's not my daddy. It's not my sister, not my brother. But it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Yeah, I need you. Like I never needed you before. I need you to walk with me. I need you to talk with me. I need you to tell me I'm your child. Please, God, heal, touch, deliver, and set free. And it is so. And it is so. We claim victory. We claim victory right now. We are not the head. We are the head and not the tail. We are the lender and not the borrower. We are over and not believe. We are more than conquerors through him that loved us. And so God, we pray that there are those under the sound of my voice that may not be feeling well, that as we're praying that you're performing miracles right now, that you're working situations out right now, that you're putting things back together right now, that you're restoring order right now in the name of Jesus. And we thank you and we give your name glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, clap those hands and give them praise. Come on, clap those hands and give them praise. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come on, one more time.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord wants to touch you if you allow him to touch your spirit. I feel something in here. I feel breakthrough in here. I feel deliverance. Whatever you need from God, you got to be receptive to what God is doing. You waiting on the sermon, God is saying, listen, open your mouth. Open your mouth and bless me. Bless me with the fruit of your lips. Your children will come back home. They'll act right if you bless me. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. My God. So much going on. It ain't time. It's time out to still be coming to church for formality. Or looking at what somebody, we passed all that. Too many folk dying. Too many folk losing their minds through the church. And so it's time for us to be about our Father's building. It's time for us to be about our Father's business. For a few minutes. Hallelujah. I feel a heaviness in the room. And if you're open to it, God wants to do something for you. I say if you're open to it. Soon as I stop worrying how the story ends. I let go and I let God have his way. That's when things start happening. Hey! Shakarababo, shatarabo, oh! Hey! Soon as I stop worrying, God say, I'm going to bless him because some of y'all too stout-hearted to bless him with your own mouth. I let go and I let God, yes, let God have his way. That's when things start happening. When I stop look at the young folk coming. They know they need God in their lives. Let God have it. See, this some of y'all testimony. I couldn't seem to fall asleep. There was so much on my mind. Searching for that peace, the peace I could not find. And then I kneeled down to praying, help me please. And that's when I realized you were the one. Let God have. That's when
You come and get what you need. You know you're sick and tired of being sick and tired. God wants to deliver you today. If you open your mouth soon as
I stop worrying,
to let God have his way in this place. Deliverance is taking place in this place.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Touch right now in the name of Jesus. Deliver right now in the name of Jesus. These young ladies, I don't know what they're facing. I don't know what they're going through. But I lay my hands on them as an extension of Jesus Christ, that whatever they need from you, every place that they tread, they shall have right now in the name of Jesus. They are queenly young ladies right now in the name of Jesus. So touch right now, deliver right now, set free right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, soon as
I stop worrying about the story, I let go and I let God have his way. As when things start happening, I stop looking.
Clap those hands and give them praise, the Lord. God does all things well. Come on, clap those hands and give them praise. Come on, come on. Come on, bless the name of Jesus in this place. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the name of God. Bless the name of God today. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible says, when there's perfect praise, the Bible says, even the children begin to worship. Huh. Soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, I let go and I let God, let God have his way. That's when things start happening. I stopped looking at back then. I let go and I let God. Let God have his way. The word of the Lord says for today, don't stop worshiping. I'm just going to give you this little nugget. The word of the Lord says today, Psalm 37. commit thy way unto the Lord. That's what God is calling for today. We commit to everybody else, but God is saying, commit your way unto me. And if you commit your way unto me, look what can happen. Commit thy way to the Lord. That's the word for the day. The door of the church is open. The door of the church is open. Somebody need to come. God bless you. God bless you. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on. The door is open. They're coming. They're coming. I know the Spirit has moved in this place. This is the place that you need to be. You need to be in a worship setting like this. We ain't judging you. We ain't looking at the outward appearance. We're worried about your soul. We're worried about your soul. The door is open for you today. God bless you, my sister. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. That ain't all. That ain't all. That ain't all. That ain't all. God said, it's about five of you in here. The song has ministered to your heart. The song has ministered to your heart. Soon as I stop worrying, worrying how the story ends, I let go and I let God. That ain't all. That ain't all. The Spirit is moving on some of y'all hearts today. You know this the place that you need to be. Come on down. That's when things start. God bless you. Happening. God bless you. They're coming from everywhere. They're coming from the back. They're coming from the front. Come on, praise God. Come on, praise God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Yeah. You can come from the balcony. God said, it's some students in here. You away from home. You know your mama told you. You know your daddy told you to get in a church. You can join on the watch care today. You can join on the watch care today. Come down. If you're afraid to walk, tell your neighbor to walk with me. Walk with me. This was for you today. It's time for you to re-up. It's time for you to commit unto the Lord. It's time for you to commit unto the Lord. The door is open today. I let go and I let God. That's it. Let God. That's it, my sister. That's when things start happening. I stop looking at back then. That ain't all. I let go and I let God. Let God. That's it. That's it. Soon as I stop worrying, worrying about the story. I let go and I let God. It's time for you to commit today. This word is for you. Commit thy ways unto the Lord. That's when things start happening. I stop looking at back then. I let go and I let go. Let go. This is what some of y'all need to do. Let go. Let go. Let go. And let God. You can't carry it on your own. You've had enough. Let go. And let God. Oh, let go. Let God. Let go. And let God. My sister, let go. My brother, let go. Let go and let God. Soon as I stop worrying how the story ends.
Come on, support the Lord in this place. Come on. Come on, give him glory. Thank God for the harvest these people have committed unto the Lord today. Come on, you can do better than that. Nobody can take the credit for what God, our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome, they're still coming. They're still coming. God is awesome. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, God. Woo! Yes, God. There's nobody like our God. I said, there's nobody like our God. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater than you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Man, I don't see how y'all still sitting there. I feel like running. I really do. I don't understand. The Bible says when one comes, heaven rejoices. I know heaven having a good time. And watch this. What God continues to do is he keeps confirming and affirming that, watch this, there's no place like the Oasis Baptist Church. There's no place like this place. You can't keep coming here. You're going to get stuck. The Holy Ghost will arrest you because we let God have his way. I'm so glad and I'm so honored to understand, even though I've been to seminary, the seminary didn't teach me about the Holy Ghost. And I know, and I'm intelligent enough to know that when the Holy Ghost moves, ain't nothing I can say, ain't nothing I can do that can talk what the Holy Ghost can do. These folk have come today because God moved on their heart, and we thank God that God continues to affirm our work here and what we're doing. All right, we have 8 for Christian Experience. Amen. When I call your name, just stand. Diamond Lucius. That's right, amen. All right, Deja Bishop, amen, Christian Experience. The Grants, Pamela and David. Come on, give God praise for that. Amen, our deacon's parents. Come on, our deacon's parents, they travel with us, and we thank God for that. Dion Henry, amen. Alexandra Ward. All right. Danielle Black, amen. Phyllis Fisher, amen. All right, I think that's it. And then we have one that wants to rededicate, amen. Little Sister Crowell, amen. Amen, Kiana, amen. God bless you. Amen. It's a blessing to want to rededicate yourself to God. Amen. Amen. She's committed her way. She heard what the scripture said, and the Spirit moved on her heart to rededicate herself. One thing I love about salvation is once we save, we always save. Hallelujah. Amen. We can do stuff that's not pleasing to God, but the devil can never pluck us out of his hand. And that's why I'm glad, watch this, he holds my hand, because if I hold his hand, I'll let it go. That's why his rod and his staff comforts me. Oh my God, his staff beats stuff away, but his rod has a hook on it that when I get too far out there,
He ain't going to come where I am, but he'll put his hook out there. And what he has happened, what he has done to Sister Crowell, he hooked her and brought her back in. Y'all don't know when to shout, do you? Thank God for hooking us and pulling us back in. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we thank God for you. We thank God for your tenacity and your courage to come and stand and rededicate your life. Amen. God bless you. All of you, welcome, welcome. We thank God for you. Amen, amen. You can stand and go back to your seat. Amen. Thank you so very much. Whoa, God is good. God is good. I ain't think God can move with no jeans, with me having no jeans on. I thought I had to have on a suit and a tie. Unorthodox. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 As we stand, as we stand, as we stand, let us stand. Amen. Everybody touching somebody. God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill, do you believe it? Every promise to you. Don't give up on God, for he won't give up on you. He's able. How many of you believe he's able today? Come on, he showed us today that he's able. Just when we're about to give up, he's able. Yes, yes, God, yes, God. Come on, come on. Oh, we're gonna, oh, oh, oh. Seen and what our ears have heard and what our hearts have felt. Thank you for reminding us in Psalm 37 that we should commit our ways to you. We thank you for how your spirit has reigned in this place. Thank you for touching our young people right now. God, we thank you for your anointing that is fresh, that is not just for adults, but it's for all. And so, God, we thank you for showing yourself mighty in this place. You have healed, you have delivered, you have set free. And so, God, we pray for every person that's under the sound of my voice. We ask, God, that you anoint us, appoint us, approve us right now in the name of Jesus. Now, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, may the rest of the Bible with us henceforth and forevermore. Let us all say amen. Hug somebody, tell them you love them. There's nothing they can do about it. And tell them he's able. Members, just for...